Cat, welcome back to Cat News. I hope that you're all having a great day today. And in national news, we're going to be talking about something that I'm kind of shocked to hear, something that I took for granted during this pandemic, and that is meat products. So yes, meat processing plants across the United States are suspending operations as a result of the pandemic, and poultry giant Tyson is warning that the closures could cause major gaps in the country's food supply chain. The Tyson of Chairman Foods said millions of pounds of meat could disappear from grocery stores and restaurants, and millions of chickens, pigs, and cows could be depopulated, which is just another word for they could be killed, because farmers have no place to sell their livestock, and there's no one in these plants to process them. You know, there's no one to take care of this meat. And such a scenario is already happening in some states. We have two states that they're already seeing this, which is Delaware and Maryland, where 2 million chickens are set to be euthanized due to a lack of employees in the region's chicken processing plants. So yes, it is definitely something to be aware of. Be aware that the longer this goes on, you know, there might be more incidences where you can go in the supermarket and there will be a shortage of meat products. So yeah, that's where that news story is. Definitely just something to be aware of and keep on your mind when you're going food shopping. So yes, in some other news, today's day in history is back in 1788, Maryland became the seventh state to ratify the Constitution. And for me, that doesn't sound like that too long ago, but when you do the math, that's actually 232 years ago. So yes, that's all for national news. Over to local news.
Hey guys, it's Kiana. I'm gonna give you local news. So in local news, we have some pictures from last week's elementary school spirit week. The last day was Friday and it was Aloha Friday. So here are some pictures of that. And finally, the high school can show off how much spirit we have with our own spirit week, which is this week. So yesterday's day was Furball Fun Day. And so you got to showcase off you and your pet. So here are some of those pictures. So today's Spirit Week Day is Twinning Tuesday. So for Twinning Tuesday, you can either choose a virtual friend or you can choose someone in your house to twin with. So make sure that you guys get those pictures in if you want them on the Cat News Instagram or on the next Cat News episode. And so tomorrow's day is Bruin Pride Day, so make sure you guys are wearing blue and gold and representing your Bruin Pride. And some other news, seniors, I know you guys have been getting the emails from Miss Christella about the locker pickup. Please make sure you respond to her with your appropriate day and the time that is best for you to be able to go pick up your stuff from your locker. That's all for local news. Over to sports.
Hi, my name is Elmi, and today I'll be giving you national sports. The NFL draft was this past week, and the draft usually lasts for about 3 days. It started the 23rd, which was Thursday, and ended Saturday, the 25th. The Eagles had a few notable pickups to mention. In round one, they selected Jalen Reagor, the wide receiver out of TCU. In the second, they selected quarterback Jalen Hurts. In the third round, they picked up linebacker Davion Taylor from Colorado. And in the fourth, they chose safety Kayvon Wallace out of Clemson. Those are just a few of the players that they took in the draft. And Saturday, the Eagles also acquired wide receiver Marquise Goodwin from the 49ers off a trade. So it looks like now that the Eagles have a couple more options at the wide receiver position. We know we saw that this year they kind of struggled with receivers as many of them were getting injured. But now it looks like that shouldn't be the problem for this upcoming year. And that's all I have for National. Let's check up on Nayeli. Let's see what she's doing.
Hi, I'm Nayeli, and welcome back to another episode of What is Nayeli Doing Today? And today I'll be making brookies. For you guys who don't know what that is brownie cookies. So here's that. Enjoy.
Follow me.
you guys enjoy that, because I definitely enjoyed eating that little piece because it is so good and so great. I never made it homemade. I usually always order it or something, but it is delicious and I recommend you guys make it. So stay tuned for the next episode of What Is Nayeli Doing Today. Bye. Now over to weather with Waleska.
Good morning, Kat. Welcome back to Weather with Waleska. The current temperature is 45 degrees outside with a wind speed headed towards the northwest at 5 miles per hour. And the humidity today is up to 67%. The temperature will rise up to 62 degrees later on around 4 and 5 p.m.-ish. And it will die back down to the 50s later on throughout the day. Today will mainly consist of clouds and a little bit of sun peeking through. Unlike yesterday, where I took another video from my house to show you how dull the clouds looked and there was not very much sun. So that is indicating that it will rain soon throughout this week. Just a heads up to make sure you're in mind, to keep in mind. On to the weather fact of the day. Did you know that you could tell the temperature by counting a cricket's chirps? That's all I have for weather. Have a great day, Kat.